Everywhere you look, Byron Bay is a picture postcard.
We're in Byron Bay and we are just checking in to this awesome Airbnb.
Forget hotels or campgrounds, short-term rental accommodation like Airbnbs, a hot property.
This place is unreal. It's insane.
At least 1,100 homes in Byron have been converted into unhosted short-term holiday rentals. It's great for visitors.
The kitchen, ta-da!
But the local council worries too many homes are becoming hotel rooms and affordable housing for workers could soon be all but wiped out.
I'm worried about this community. I'm worried about all the people I know that have already left, all the people that are talking about leaving. I'm worried about all the jobs that people can't hire for because they're not willing to come to a place where they have to spend so much of their money on rent.
Byron's mayor believes he's fighting for the soul of Byron Bay. If he can't quarantine homes for workers, the town will self-destruct.
I honestly believe if we don't get that balance right, we will cook that goose and Grand Byron will be damaged.
Hi, welcome to Byron.
The council's solution is to slash the limit on holiday rentals like this from 180 days a year to just 90.
Byron really is the canary in the coal mine. Other areas within Australia are watching what happens in Byron and we need to make sure that other local areas and communities aren't decimated under a planning policy like this.
Sarah Workman was Byron Bay's tourism officer for 10 years.
I love the courtyard.
Yeah.
Now she's leading an aggressive campaign against council's proposed 90-day limit.
So a property like this, it's a four-bedroom and four-bathroom with a couple of living areas and two swimming pools. In peak season, that would be about $12,000 a week, and in off-peak, it's about $5,000 a week. And roughly 50% of what the owners earn as part of this goes back into the local community. Plumbers, electricians, window cleaners, pest control, house cleaners. We'll see 1,500 jobs lost under this new policy and also 300 million removed from the local economy each and every year.
An absolute fabrication. You would have to wipe out the entire holiday letting industry in Byron Shire to get anywhere even close to that figure.
A war of words has erupted with the council accused of killing tourism and Airbnb warning of irreversible consequences.
Byron Shire Council is proposing to wipe out short-term holiday rentals in Byron Bay.
In this famously chilled-out town, many are now hot under the collar.
I've been called a psychopath, have no empathy, I'm a monster.
It has gotten personal. It's been surprising, really. It sort of shows a lack of class.
To muddy the water even further, Sarah's pro-Airbnb group is calling itself Byron Deserves Better, almost identical to Byron Deserves Balance, which opposes Airbnbs.
They want to confuse people.
Liz Friend's campaign supporting the 90-day cap has collected more than 2,000 signatures.
Oh, we've got a lot more signatures now, which is great.
They'll be presented at a public inquiry next month.
One woman said to me, well, Liz, the rich move in, the poor have just got to move on, haven't they? It'll just be a place for the wealthy.
They see that we're greedy. Greedy people are renting out houses short-term, making huge gains. That's not the case.
Grant Moffat is an entrepreneur who rents some of his homes long-term to locals, but this five-bedder is for holiday makers. Today, cleaners are getting the place ready for new guests.
I believe I'm not causing a problem. I'm just meeting a need, and this house is ideal, as you can see, for a family group.
In fact, Grant argues he and his fellow investors are filling a vacuum in tourist accommodation created by the council's decades-long resistance to approving new housing and hotel developments.
It's allowed families to have a holiday, a beach holiday, to come to a great place like Byron Bay, spending money in the town, creating jobs.
Under pressure from the Airbnb lobby, last month the New South Wales government hit the pause button on Byron Bay's proposed 90-day cap. A final decision won't be made until after an independent review and the state election. In the meantime, businesses are taking extreme measures to keep their doors open.
It was harder and harder for our staff to find anywhere long-term or medium-term to live.
Ben and Belinda Kirkwood run a popular beachside restaurant. Most of the customers are visitors and all the staff are locals. They took the drastic step of opening their own home to their workers while they moved into an Airbnb.
When Ben came home and said he's decided to move the staff into our house, it was a bit like, well, okay, thanks.
It was inconvenient, but at the time it was desperate times, desperate measures.
It's the perfect fix, but one that's out of reach for most, leaving the rest of Byron wondering,
how do we accommodate both the staff and the tourists at the same time?
I don't think anyone can blame us for wanting to make sure we've got the right amount of housing supply to satisfy the jobs in our community and to get the balance right in our community.
This property will sit empty for 270 days of the year. That's the reality of it. It's like killing the golden goose.
There's always been tourism in Byron Bay. I mean, how big does it have to get? I rest my case.
You're from up that way.
Okay, I'm going to duck hood now.
Your neighbours are watching.
Does it feel, as it's someone that lives there, does it feel like Byron is bursting at the seams?
Look, I think the issue that Byron is an incredible place. It's a magical place. What made it so magical is the artisans, the dreamers, the people who work in hospitality. It is a tourist town. We know that. But they're being pushed out. They've got nowhere to live. And as one of our interviewees there said, some of these houses sit empty for 270 days of the year. So it's about balance. I understand that it brings an influx of money and people need somewhere for a holiday, but maybe house swapping. Maybe if you don't live in the Shire and you're renting out a house that you don't live in, maybe a 20% sleep tax. Maybe some of the things that we can look at that can then be reinserted in the community in building infrastructure, because we don't have any other industry beyond tourism.
Is it not all the celebrities moving up there, Madeline?
Oh! Are you talking about the Hemsworth effect?
Where's he supposed to live? He's got a compound, you know, he's going to put it in Sydney. The prices, they can't afford it. He's found it a very affordable compound for him to live in.
Now, Byron's proposed 90-day cap is being reviewed by the New South Wales Independent Planning Commission. Submissions from the public close on March 2. For more information, just head to our website.